Deadly Israeli airstrikes have intensified in central and southern Gaza following Iran's massive drone and missile attack. At least 11 Palestinians have been killed, including children, in strikes on a refugee camp in Deir Al-Balah. Further south in Rafah, several more people have been killed after a residential building was destroyed.
Every day, daily, there's targeting in Rafah. There's no safe place, not in Rafah, nor in Khan Yunis, or in Gaza City, and not in the entire Gaza Strip.
The IDF has released new video of its latest strikes in southern Lebanon. Three people have been killed, including a Hezbollah commander who's believed to have been travelling in a car which was destroyed. Israel is vowing to strike back against Iran. US Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen has warned the United States intends to punish Iran with new sanctions in the coming days, which could target the country's oil industry. Our CBS colleague Deborah Patter has more from Jerusalem.
Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu rallying the troops as he met with a new group of conscripts today. This is part of a larger battle, he told them. Iran is behind Hamas and Hezbollah. We are determined to beat them. His war cabinet met today for the third time since the Iranian attack. A senior American official tells CBS News Israel has not shared its plans with the US, but some in the administration expect a limited strike inside Iran. But the fear of an all-out regional war has distracted attention away from the misery in Gaza. There are still regular airstrikes each day, bringing new grief. Gaza is tired, said Dalia Abu Amsha. We live in humiliation, in poverty and in death. The United Nations says there has been no significant change in the amount of aid trickling in. In the north, there were desperate lines for bread after supplies from the World Food Programme brought this bakery back to life for the first time in over 6 months. Food prices have soared. Banks are running out of cash. Fed up with living in tents in Rafah, thousands defied Israeli orders and tried to return to their homes in the north over the weekend. But they were turned around. The IDF says this is still an active war zone.
A senior Israeli government official has told CBS News that a Rafah invasion will happen. It is not a matter of if, but when, but would not be drawn on a date or whether it's been delayed because of the Iranian